Hi, today we are going to talk about Krellogic model in procurement. This model was developed by Mr. Peter Krellogic, who first formulated this model in his article called Purchasing Must Become Supply Management, and it was published in Harvard Business Review in 1983. In its original form, Krellogic matrix is used for mapping of purchases, not the supplier. However, the matrix works equally well to distinguish different categories of the suppliers according to the products what we are buying from them. In supply chain management, the Krellogic matrix or model is a strategic tool used by procurement and supply chain professionals to identify and minimize the supply risks in procurement. Using the tool to classify the importance of suppliers' product, their services, and can highlight supply chain weaknesses of suppliers, and then can develop support strategy, and then minimize the supply disruptions. So determine the type of relationship we can develop with the suppliers by positioning them by risk and profit impact will support procurement and supply chain professional to build the right types of supply relationship and utilize the time more efficiently while mitigating the supply risk for their organizations. So these were the purposes and the objectives of the Krellogic matrix in procurement. Okay, in this matrix we used to have a segment of the purchases or suppliers of a company by dividing them into four different classes based on its complexity or risk of supply markets, such as monopoly situation, barriers to entry, technological innovations, and the importance of purchases or supplier determined by the impact of they have on the profitability of the company. Basically, this sum division allows us to define the optimal purchasing strategy for each of the four types of the purchases or suppliers, which we are going to discuss in coming section of this presentation. Okay, the model is like we determine risk versus the potential profit or the revenue in the procurement process. So on vertical side, we labeled risk is concerned with the degree of difficulty associated with sourcing a product or a service or a vulnerability of the supplier to provide the product or service on the time. And on the horizontal side, we put the profit potential is used to indicate the extent of the potential of supply to contribute to the profitability or efficiency of buying concern. This profit potential might be realized by achieving lower cost, either by paying a lower price for a good or services, or by introducing more efficient buying methods. So this way we can identify the risks and the profit potential of a supplier. Okay, the commodities or the services which we are, companies wishes to develop a tailored procurement strategy can be ranked as high or low in terms of both risk exposure or the procurement potential, like we have in the previous part discussed. So first we will rank our products or services according to the risk exposure and the potential in the procurement. The score of an item in respect of each of these criteria determines the positioning of that commodity or service on a procurement positioning or targeting matrix. So first we will rank our products according to our risk and the potential procurement, then we will place them in the Krellogic matrix and then develop the strategy a procurement strategy. So how we will this quadrant of the matrix represent the four categories, which are critical products, leverage products, bottlenecked, and routine. So you can see from the picture that how, after ranking them, how we will place them in the matrix. So now let's define that how we will be categorizing or ranking our products. So for non-critical or routine items, components, those have a low impact on company and that are found in abundance and are in low risk market. That is like very common, or like example is like office stationery. For such items, the goal should be maximize efficiency of the procurement process to reduce the administrative cost or burden. For example, for delegating purchasing to a local manager or using catalogs or making is automatic. Then comes the leverage items, component that are important for company but sourced from low risk market with an abundant supply. So as the name suggests, the optimal management of these purchases category is essential to ensure a satisfactory business result. For this type of products, the company tends to make the most of its bargaining power and abundance of the offer with frequent negotiation. Continuing the types of commodity and services, then comes the bottleneck items, a component with a low business impact in the economic term, but where supply continuity is at risk. So they are not very expensive, but their availability is a issue. The management of these components should be aimed at creating relationship of collaboration in the medium or long term between the customer and supplier to guarantee the supply with less emphasis on the cost. So here we have to develop the good relationship with our suppliers so they can continually providing these products to us. Then the last but not the least is the most important items, which are strategic items or critical item for our business. The component those are very important for the company, both in terms of economic impact or for the supply condition from complex to risky markets. In this field, horizon is medium long range term with a continuous monitoring of economic situation of markets, technical evaluation to make or buy, creation of alternatives, and development of stable relationship and maximum collaboration with the suppliers. So here we have to develop the relationship. We have also think about making it at home or buying it, and keep always a very close monitoring of these products in the procurement process. So here is a chronologic supply matrix, which in a one go you can see that for bottlenecked items which are like at high risk, supply risk, we should ensure the supply, acquire the capability, create capability, or invest in suppliers. Then in non-critical or routine items, simplify and automate, and we have to have a multiple suppliers and create a warm base with our suppliers. Then on the other side, for leverage items, exploit purchasing power and minimize the cost. So invest in suppliers to ensure timely availability. And in strategic items, which are like high risk and high value impact on our profitability or our business, form partnerships, acquire capability, create new in-house capabilities and new business unit. So this is in this picture you can see that how we place the our products and services categorized wise, and then how we develop the strategy to achieve our objective in a procurement process by using the chronologic supply matrix. Okay, following the classification of risk impact and cost profit value impact to your business, that each supplier potentially holds, you can then identify the type of relationship that you should consider building with supplier and how to mitigate the supplier risk to your organizations. So once we have placed or positioned our product according to their risk exposure and profit potential, we then develop a relationship with our suppliers accordingly to mitigate our supply risk and increase our efficiency in the procurement for our organization. At the end of this presentation, I'm going to wrap it up. Like the purpose of this matrix is to set up a base for supplier-based segmentation. That how we have to segment divide our suppliers. Then each quadrant provides a clear picture of resources, priorities, and objective. Setting up a segmentation strategy, executing it can be very time-consuming and challenging due to the balance of power in each segment. Then metrics need to be reviewed frequently due to dynamic supply base changes. So we have to review it, and maybe we are changing the quadrant of the product accordingly. Please have in mind that supplier can also make segmentations analysis in there for their customers as well. So you should think this in your mind. Despite its age, this matrix is even today one of the most powerful segmentation tool used across various industries and companies to strategize their procurement process. So this was the end of the presentation. Please, if you have any question, don't feel any hesitation to ask me in comment section. Thank you again for your time.